Hey y'all, it's Monica. It's about almost 6 a.m. and I have been up since about 3 o'clock this morning. If you don't know already, I kind of have, well, I don't know that I have sleep problems, but my sleep varies sometimes. Most of the time I can get to bed between 8 and 9:30, especially during the work week. And when I do that, I am usually wide awake by like 2 in the morning. So I'll get up, because once I wake up, I can't go back to sleep. I have trouble going back to sleep. So I'll get up, I'll do a load of laundry, I'll unload the dishwasher, do some chores. And then about 4:30 or 5, I'll get sleepy again and sleep another hour and then get up and get ready for work. That is my routine probably four times a week during the work week. Then on the weekends, I usually try to sleep in a little bit. I really do try. I try to make myself stay awake at least until 10, 11 sometimes, and then try to force myself to sleep until 6. It doesn't happen, though. So, for example, last night, I made myself stay up till at least 11, and I was up by 3. So I'm tired right now, but I know that if I go to sleep right now, it will keep me awake that much longer tonight, because that's the way I get. So I'm going to try to stay awake the whole day so that I will be tired tonight and I can sleep a solid night. But I was just here watching Texas Mom's latest YouTube video, Fast Food is Evil, I Tell Ya. And I thought I'd better go ahead and respond, because with this lack of sugar, and by the way, my sleep is not contributed to like caffeine or anything, because I haven't had caffeine since October. All I'm drinking is water. So no sugar, no caffeine. I really don't know. My sleep is just, it's always been that way. I think I'm used to getting up by 3 or 4 every morning anyway, and so my body just adjusts to that, and I've never been much of a napper. So once I'm awake, and it's hard for me to go back to sleep. But anyway, back to Texas Mom's video. She was saying that she had gone to McDonald's and her husband had picked up some breakfast for her and was sharing those calories, and how eye-opening it was that her oatmeal was a lot healthier than the oatmeal at McDonald's, and how before she would have thought, before her, I think she has a sleeve. Yeah, she has a sleeve. Before her sleeve and all these changes she's made and this journey she's going through, she would have thought mentally that breakfast was a healthy choice for her. And now realizing that she's not. So now that I've been off of sugar for 2 or 3 months now, 2.5 months, and my taste buds are changing. You know, I commented saying my stomach is now realizing that what my brain has already known. Because I have mentally known that fast food is not good for you, but did it stop me from going to eat fast food? No. So, and not that I won't eat it in the future, but just the way things are tasting, it's not tasting like something that I want anymore. So yeah, I think that I'm finally starting to realize what that inner fat girl of me is and how she thinks. You know, I know that that's a part of me. The fat girl in me is part of me. So even though my mind always knew things weren't good for me, it never stopped me from doing that, because the fat girl in me overpowered the sensible person, the sensible Monica. So anyway, that was pretty enlightening for me, and thank you, Texas Mom, for posting that. I really learned a lot, and I just want to share that with y'all while I was awake and online. Sorry for the messy hair and no makeup. All right, well, I'm about to, I guess, finish cleaning up and then get ready for church. So I will talk to y'all later. See y'all. Bye.